Good morning, sisters and brothers. Welcome to another act of worship with the Pro-Cathedral and Parish of St. George with St. Barnabas. Let us prepare our hearts for worship. Let us pray. Loving God, you have touched our bodies. You have awakened us to see another day. And as you have opened our eyes, as you have stirred that spirit within us, help us now by your grace, that we may open wide our mouths to give you thanks and praise, that we would open wide our hearts to receive you and to invite you to enter afresh. Go before us now, O God, with your most gracious favor. Lead us in this act of worship. Lead us into deeper communion with yourself. And may we leave this virtual space refreshed, ready and willing once again to do your will in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We turn to our prayer books, page 33. For from the rising of the sun to its setting, my name is great among nations, and in every place incense is offered to my name.
And a pure offering.
For my name is great among the nations, says the Lord of hosts. We use section 2 of the versicles and responses. Hear us, O Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We will exalt you, O God, our Savior.
And praise your name forever and ever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness.
Let our worship
be a witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Good night. O come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his face with thanksgiving and cry out to him joyfully in psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he himself is our God. We are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. If only you would hear his voice today, for he comes to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. As we pause, we recall to mind any sins, any situations that we have been struggling with, not just this early morning, but those situations that have persisted in our lives over the past days, maybe months, even years. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Appointed Psalm is Psalm 88. Psalm 88. We turn to page 582. O Lord, my God, my Savior. By day and night, I cry to you.
Let my prayer enter into your presence. Incline your ear to my lamentation.
For I am full of trouble. My life is at the brink of the grave.
I am counted among those who go down to the pit. I have become like one who has no strength.
Lost among the dead, like the slain who lie in the grave.
Whom you remember no more, for they are cut off from your hand.
You have laid me in the depths of the pit, in dark places and in the abyss.
Your anger weighs upon me heavily, and all your great waves overwhelm me.
You have put my friends far from me. You have made me to be abhorred by them. I am in prison and cannot get free.
My sight has failed me because of trouble. Lord, I have called upon you daily. I have stretched out my hands to you.
Do you work wonders for the dead? Will those who have died stand up and give you thanks?
Will your loving kindness be declared in the grave? Your faithfulness in the land of destruction?
Will your wonders be known in the dark? Or your righteousness in the country where all is forgotten?
But as for me, O Lord, I cry to you for help. In the morning, my prayer comes before you.
Lord, why have you rejected me? Why have you hidden your face from me?
Ever since my youth, I have been wretched and at the point of death. I have borne your terrors with a troubled mind.
Your blazing anger has swept me over. Your terrors have destroyed me.
They surround me all day long like a flood. They encompass me on every side.
My friend and my neighbor, you have put away from me. And darkness is my only companion. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Amen. Our first reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, verses 1 through 9.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 61, reading verses 1 through 9. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. Strangers shall stand and feed your flocks. Foreigners shall till your land and dress your vines. But you shall be called priests of the Lord. You shall be named ministers of our God. You shall enjoy the wealth of the nations, and in their riches you shall glory. Because their shame was double, and dishonor was proclaimed at their lot, therefore they shall possess a double portion. Everlasting joy shall be theirs. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We turn to our hymn books, number 278, 278. And we will read or recite the words of this hymn. We read the words together. Holy Spirit, truth divine, dawn upon this soul of mine. Voice of God and inward light, wake my spirit, clear my sight. Holy Spirit, love divine, glow within this heart of mine. Kindle every high desire, perish self in thy pure fire. Holy Spirit, power divine, fill and nerve this will of mine. By thee may I strongly live, bravely bear, and nobly strive. Holy Spirit, law divine, reign within this soul of mine. Be my law, and I shall be firmly bound, forever free. Holy Spirit, peace divine, still this restless heart of mine. Speak to calm this tossing sea, sail in thy tranquility. Holy Spirit, joy divine, gladden thou this heart of mine. In the desert ways I sing, spring, O well, forever spring. Amen. Now we'll have our second reading. Second reading comes to us from Mark chapter 10, verses 32 to 45.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Mark, chapter 10, reading verses 32 to 45. They were on the road going up to Jerusalem, and Jesus was walking ahead of them. They were amazed, and those who followed were afraid. He took the 12 aside again and began to tell them what was to happen to him, saying, "See, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be handed over to the chief priests and the scribes, and they will condemn him to death. Then they will hand him over to the Gentiles. They will mock him and spit upon him and flog him and kill him. And after 3 days, he will rise again." James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came forward to him and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And he said to them, "What is it you want me to do for you?" And they said to him, "Grant us to sit, one at your right hand and one at your left, in your glory." But Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?" They replied, "We are able." Then Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right hand or at my left is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they began to be angry with James and John. So Jesus called them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant. And whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We turn to our hymn books, and the hymn 304, "Brother, Sister, Let Me Serve You, Let Me Be As Christ To You." 304. Well, I think that hymn gave us our little message for this morning. But it's close to Lent. We are just about the end of Epiphany. One more Sunday to go. And we see how the readings already begin to shift emphasis a bit. This morning, from the first reading, we hear how the promised Messiah describes himself. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, or upon him, as it were. And so the coming Messiah is presented as one who is Spirit-filled, and he's Spirit-filled to proclaim, to heal, to bless, to anoint, to set free, to release, to bring about an abundant form of life for all who will choose to follow him. And so this Spirit-filled Messiah, we see and understand from Isaiah as one who is coming to release people from all that imprisons them. And so he comes not as a mighty conqueror who will crush and destroy, but one who will love and will serve. And so we can see the contrast with the second reading from Mark, where the disciples of Jesus, they still understand or interpret Jesus, their leader, to be this mighty leader and king who will eventually crush the Roman government. You know, he's very nice in terms of his leadership, but they believe that at some point, you know, there's going to be a specific turning point where he crushes Roman rule, and the Jews will rise again, as in the days of King David, and they will take over their own country, their own lives, and they will live as they believe God wants them to live. But the message that Jesus gives, as the scripture tells us, he explains to them again and again. He doesn't just say to them once, he explains to them again and again that the Son of Man, their leader, he himself, Jesus, will suffer and die. They don't get it. They don't get it. So they still ask of him. They pull him aside, say, Jesus, when you come into your kingdom, you know, we've been good boys. We are following you faithfully. You know, me and my brother, can you put one of us on your left hand and put one of us on your right hand? And Jesus, we get a sense, is just pained in his heart. And it's like, you guys are not getting it. He said, listen, can you drink the cup that I am going to drink? Can you be baptized with the baptism that I will be baptized with? And because they don't get it, they respond, yeah, we can do it. We can drink the cup and we can be baptized. And Jesus says, yeah, you're really going to be baptized with the baptism that I'm going to be baptized with. Because Jesus knows that in the future, not too far, you know, from after the time of his death, that his immediate disciples, the 12, that they too are going to suffer for being his followers. And so Jesus, he explains or teaches them that position in God's kingdom is not his to give, and that is not what he's about. He is here to release humanity from all encumbrances, and he's going to do so not by might and power to crush, but by might and power to love and serve. Our freedom in Christ comes from Christ's freedom to love us and to serve us. And so he explains to them, those who rule over the Gentiles, they lord it over them. You know, they express that kind of arrogance and boastfulness over them, and they look down upon them, they condescend. It says, but us, those of us who believe in Jesus and follow him, he says, that's not what we are about. We are about service. So we will not lord it over anyone and make anyone feel as though they are less than or that we are better than. Rather, we will serve them. So the hymn we would have just heard and sung, for some of us it might be a bit new. It's a bit somewhat new to me, but a lovely hymn. And the first verse in particular, we don't have to go very far. The first verse, brother, sister, let me serve you. Let me be as Christ to you. Pray that I may have the grace to let you be my servant too. And that latter part, I think, is where many of us have a challenge. As Christians, there are those of us who are happy to extend our hand to help and to show that we are willing to help and make things better, make life better for others. But when it is time to switch roles, we oftentimes are too full of pride to humble ourselves and to allow others to minister to us. And so, in a very silent way, we behave very haughtily. No, it's okay, I'm okay, it's all right. When truly we are very much in need of the help. And something that we oftentimes overlook when we deny others the opportunity to love us in return and to help us in return, we deny them the opportunity to be as Christ to us. We feel much more comfortable being Christ to others. And we do not recognize at times the pain, the disappointment we bring to others by not allowing them to minister to us. So we believe and we feel good as Christians when we can do it, but we do not feel good as Christians to allow others to be Christ to us. How disappointing can that be? How disappointing when we do not allow others to allow that Christ to come forth in them. We shut them up, we block them, we deny them, we limit them, and very often they leave with very heavy hearts, because in our own blindness, in our own ignorance, we have acted haughtily. Although we've been very nice and pleasant, no, it's okay, thank you very much for the offer, but I'm fine, you know, somebody else might need the help. They want to help us. So this morning, as we are called to reflect once again upon what it means to serve, what it means to serve, let us consider what it means to switch roles as well. that we not only must we be Christ to others, but we must be able to humble ourselves and put aside our pride and let others be Christ to us too. And so often we find there are many Christians with very good intentions and well-meaning, but we fail to recognize how our pride and our haughtiness denies others the opportunity to express their Christian love for us and their willingness to help us and to bless us. So, as we go forward today, we want to be very mindful that not only are we called to follow Christ, but others are called to follow him too. We are not the only Christians around. So let others minister to us. Allow us, let us humble ourselves and accept the blessing that God is offering through the ministry of others to us. Today, we will not harden our hearts, but with soft and willing hearts, with hearts that have been well plowed up like good and fertile soil, we will allow God's word to penetrate, to remain, and to produce bountifully. And just as we so desire it for ourselves, let us desire it for others. Amen.
Amen.
So with those few words, let us now return to page 42 of our prayer books, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us,
that we may know the joy of your salvation.
Grant peace within and among all nations,
and teach our leaders wisdom.
Endow your church with faithfulness,
and her servants with knowledge and true godliness.
Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed,
that your justice may be known among all people.
Lord, renew your spirit within us,
that in us and through us your will may be done.
Our collect on page 161, the fifth Sunday after the Epiphany, we pray, set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We turn back to page 46. We offer the prayer, the collect for Fridays. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross, that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your Spirit, that we, reaching forth our hands in love,
may bring those
who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen. And so, sisters, brothers, as we continue in prayer, we indeed are thankful to Almighty God for spared life, for another opportunity to worship and to fellowship, to hear His word. We give thanks indeed that we can have this opportunity to do still better, live better for our God. As we give God thanks and praise for this new day, we also remember and we acknowledge the lives, the souls that did not make it through the night. Pray for those who have died during the past night, early this morning. We pray for grieving families and friends who have awakened to hear the sad news of the death of their loved ones. We pray, acknowledging those who even now are lying on their deathbeds. And we pray, especially remembering the many who are unfortunately but understandably denied the opportunity of having their loved ones at their bedside during this era, this season of the COVID-19 pandemic. We pray that those who lie on their deathbeds, they may have the confidence to know that our God is with them. For those without faith, we pray that God in His mercy may look upon them. We pray that those who have chosen the way of Christ, they would go forth with the confidence, the assurance, the blessed assurance that Jesus is theirs, that they do not walk alone, and that even by faith they have many, many brothers and sisters who remember them, who lift them up in prayer, who journey with them in spirit. We pray that God will be merciful to them and receive them into His kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
This morning we pray with our theme in mind of service. We are spirit-filled and spirit-blessed by God to love and to serve, just as our Lord Jesus came not to lord it over others, but to serve. This morning we pray for our diocesan adult organizations. Pray for our Mothers Union, our Brotherhood of St. Andrew, for our Anglican Church Women. We pray for Dr. Linda Banks, the diocesan president of the Mothers Union. We are praying for Mrs. Ifina Matthew. We also remember and pray for Daughters of the King and any other organizations, adult organizations within our diocese at this time. We pray for their work. We pray for the aims and objectives of our various groups, and we pray that they will indeed work to achieve and to fulfill those goals, those aims and objectives. Mothers Union focuses on family life, brotherhood, on men and boys, Aqua, on women and girls. We pray this morning as well for all of our service providers. And so we pray during the context of this COVID-19 pandemic, our frontline workers. And so we are once again lifting up in a special way all of our healthcare providers, doctors, nurses, our paramedics, and all who are out there still fighting and battling against this virus on our behalf, taking care of our loved ones and even taking care of us. And so for all of our frontline workers, those in the health care especially, even those in the administrative field in our clinics and hospitals, We'll have to get all of the paperwork correct to assist our doctors and nurses and so on. We pray for the orderlies in our hospitals, pray for those in the laboratories behind the scenes, working feverishly to produce results, to assist and to guide our doctors and nurses in the correct treatment. We pray, Lord, for the whole healthcare systems within our various countries and worldwide. We pray for those who make up the World Health Organization, we pray for PAHO, pray for CAFA, and for all of these other regional and international groups. Pray for all of the work being done in the various laboratories throughout our world, the government labs, the private labs. Pray for all of the research and testings being done to provide vaccines and to even improve upon our vaccines, that we may offer our people the best possible assistance during this pandemic. Lord, we thank you for all involved. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
As we remember our frontline workers, we are also praying for those in the area of security. And so we pray for our police officers, we pray for our security guards at hospitals and at our ports of entry, seaports and airports. Pray for our immigration officers, our customs officers. We pray for those who provide security for us throughout the night when we are enjoying our sleep. They are those who patrol our borders. Remember our coast guards. We pray for our army, our defense force. Lord, we pray for all of them. We thank you for their work. We thank you for their service to us and to our countries. Pray for all those who are involved in private security in different areas. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for them. And we remember, especially, Lord, even their families who so often have to do without them, especially during the nights. We pray that you would keep our frontline workers and our security forces safe as they seek to defend and keep us safe from all harm and danger of every kind. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And let us also remember to pray for our those who work in our food industry. We pray for our farmers. So we start there. Our farmers who are so oftentimes overlooked, those who produce the crops, the various foods that we enjoy. Pray for our farmers involved in animal husbandry, those who help to produce all of the lovely meats that we enjoy. We pray, Lord, for those involved in fishing, our fishermen, those who traverse the seas dangerously at times, to provide us with food from the sea. Lord, we thank you for all of them, and we pray for all involved in our food production, our harvesting of food, livestock production, and the fishing and all of that, that, Lord, you bless them in their efforts, and as they seek to provide food so basic to life, that, Lord, they would go about their work in a spirit of love, and that they do their best to provide the best quality of food for us, a people. We pray, Lord, for those who, again, work behind the scenes in food production. We pray for those who work in various food institutions, seeking to provide fertilizers and other assistance to assist our farmers and so on. Those who work behind the scenes, Lord, we thank you for them. We pray for those who work within the institutions that process food. Lord, we pray for the work that they do, and we pray, Lord, for the food they produce to be of a very good quality for us to consume, and even they themselves who may consume it as well. We are praying, Lord, for our hotels, our restaurants, our food vendors in various places, as they provide the food at that final stage, cooked food for us to eat and to consume. Lord, we pray that they too will provide the service they provide will be a loving service, a service in which and through which they seek to provide a quality meal for human consumption, that they will do all within their power to ensure that they carry out the best practices for others. We remember our health department, and Lord, we thank you for their work and the work that they do, and we pray that they would remain vigilant in ensuring that all who are involved in the food industry and serving, that they would do their best to ensure that the final product, that all is of a very high standard. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And this morning we want to pray for God's church. God has called his church into being, that his church would be this beautiful, beautiful body of love, of loving service to the world. Sisters and brothers, God has called us to serve as a church, as individual Christians. Our calling is to serve each other and to serve God's world, to help to win God's world back to him. And so as a church, we pray this morning for all of our leaders throughout the world. We pray for the Pope, we pray for archbishops, bishops, priests, deacons, apostles, evangelists, Lord, church leaders of every kind, of every office. Lord, we pray for all, and we pray that there will be genuine response to the call, sincere service to your call. We pray, Lord, that wherever church leaders are, that we would all remember first and foremost that we have not called ourselves, we were called by God. And that, Lord, there are leaders who seek only to gratify themselves. We pray, O God, for your will to be done. We pray and we give thanks for Christians the world over who have answered the call to live a Christ-like life, to live as Christians, to follow Jesus. Lord, we give you thanks, and we pray today that every Christian, man, woman, and child, wherever we may be, whatever corner of the world, that we will all remember that we are called by God. We are called by God to follow the way of Christ, to be lights and witnesses of God in Jesus, and to serve our people wherever we find ourselves, to serve them, to love them, to serve in love, and to do our best to assure them of our love and to encourage them to know, to come and know the way of Christ, to accept and to receive Jesus into their lives, and to join the solution that God has called his church to be in this world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And so, Lord, we pray for the renewing and renewal of your church. Wherever your church has lost focus, O God, we pray for the leaders of the church in those areas to be brought back, to be pulled back into loving service, to remember our call is to make our world better, to make our world better, to utilize all of our gifts and resources for the benefit of others. And so we pray indeed that God's church will be the light that God has called us to be. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us now take a look at our prayer list for this morning, and let us see what our requests may be. We pray, okay, we have a prayer request for Jack Ross. Okay, Jean's son celebrating his birthday today. God's blessings upon you, Jacques. I believe that's French. We have prayers requested for our brother and sister Mr. and Mrs. William Clark, they're in St. James Nevis. We continue to lift them up. We offer our prayers for our sister Mary Walters. And similarly, remember our sister Louise and John in the nursing home. We also asked to pray, and yes, remember our sister Joycelyn as she continues to work towards better health. God's blessings upon you, Sister Joycelyn. We ask to pray for Tony in hospital. Pray for his healing and restoration. Praying for Jackie Milka. And we also asked, pray for all of our elderly. Yes, indeed, pray for all of our elderly members. And we pray that those who are confined to home or to bed, they may not ever see themselves as being useless, that they would recognize that once we have the breath of life, no matter what condition we may find ourselves in, what situation, that we would know that God has a purpose. God is working his purpose out. And even if we cannot understand it, we trust God. We trust God. God does not have us here just for style, just for a show. God has a purpose. And so from those of us who lie in our beds sick, to those of us who are standing strong, God has a purpose for every single one of us. And if we trust him, God can and will indeed work out his purpose in our lives, for our lives, and through our lives. And so we trust God to be God. Tomorrow, being Saturday, in our diocesan prayer cycle, we will be praying for St. Stephen with St. Bartholomew in Antigua. And we are lifting up Reverend Pauline Ramsey Burns and all the people there. We pray God's blessings upon them and pray that they will remain God's faithful servants and witnesses in that part of his vineyard. And so we pray for all others who celebrate at this time, be it a birthday or anniversary. And we pray, giving thanks to Almighty God, that as a church, he has brought us thus far within the church's year. And as we get closer to closing off the season of Epiphany, we look forward to the season of Lent, whereby we can once again reflect on our own lives. The revelation of God continues in Jesus. In Epiphany, we especially looked at how God revealed himself and God showing us who he is and what he is like. In Lent, the revelation continues. And so as we continue to look to Jesus, we now in Jesus allow Jesus to show us who we are. When we look at our lives in Jesus, we begin to see our shortcomings, our faults, our failures. We see our imperfections and we recognize the areas that we need to work on to become more like Jesus. So the revelation continues. We shift the emphasis, as it were. We're not only looking to see what God is like, we now look to see what we are like. Jesus is our perfect mirror. He shows us what perfect humanity must look like. And we ask God for the grace to become more like Jesus. So friends, we thank God for this another time of worship and fellowship. And as we have placed ourselves before him, as we entrust ourselves to his care, his guidance and protection, we pray indeed that wherever we tread this day, we will bring God's light and love. We bring his loving service to others. For all these mercies, Lord, we ask, and whatever we may have failed to ask of you, whatever we might be needful of, we pray that you grant unto us as you see and know best for us, in the name of Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. So we turn to page 47, and we offer our prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now, sisters and brothers, we sing our closing hymn, number 519. 519. This is our God, your servant King. From heaven you came, helpless babe. 519.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May his divine assistance be with us always. And may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. And at the appointed time, may they rise in glory. Amen. Thank you for sharing this morning. I trust you'll have a wonderful day, a blessed weekend. And if you're not worshiping at any particular church physically, please feel free to join us virtually 8:30 on Sunday morning, right here at this virtual address. God bless you, and please stay safe. Brother, sister, let me serve you. Do enjoy.
Thank you.